In 1984, long before smartphones and Google and Facebook, in fact, before most of us were in the habit of even using ATMs, Sandy Lerner was part of a small team who were exploring the potential in connecting computers. Their goal was modest, to connect the computer systems of two departments at Stanford University. The results, well, they were extraordinary, infinitely bigger. What emerged was the first computer router, which for those few maybe out there, non-computer nerds among us, is the thing that delivers so-called data packages from one place to another. In short, without this, without her, there would be no internet. Knowing they'd created something important, they set out to find backers for their invention. And this is the part really for all of us to remember. No less than 76 venture capitalists later, they were still looking. On the 77th try, they were successful, and the company we know today as Cisco Systems was born. Sandy's gone on to head up a number of successful companies, including Urban Decay and Asia Farm. Ladies and gentlemen, co-founder of Cisco Systems, one of the creators of the first computer router, Sandy Lerner.
I'm not sure why I'm here. So far listening to all of this, I think it's because I am the token left brain, right? Which makes me a true half-wit, and that's all right. First of all, I don't want to be blamed for the internet. We did something really quite different, but it's okay. Everybody likes it, so they give me these things, and that's okay. I want to talk a little bit about the other thing why I might be here, and that is the Chawton House Library and the Center for the Study of Early English Women's Writing. There were two founders of the English Royal Academy of Art who were women. Name them. There were also between 2,000 and 3,000 published women authors in the long 18th century up to and including the time of Jane Austen, who published somewhere between 10,000 and 15,000 books. And as Dale Spender said somewhat inelegantly in her wonderful book, Mothers of the Novel, almost anything that you look at that gets credited to men, there were women before, which really biologically makes a lot of sense. I mean, whatever they did, I mean, we had to do it first, right? And in starting the Center for the Study of Early English Women's Writing and starting to learn about these women and their lives and their lives of deprivation, as Jane Austen said very eloquently, single women have a dreadful propensity to being poor. I am struck time and time and time again about the times that you think that you're first and you're not. And you find mathematicians in the 13th century, and you find physicists in the 18th century. You find mathematicians who were doing things that I don't know how to do, who lived with Rousseau and died in childbirth. You find people who were astronomers and women. You know, for every Marie Curie, there's another 10 women who really didn't get the award. And I would like to do what I wrote on the bell at the Chawton House Church, and I would like to dedicate my award with my grateful thanks to Elizabeth Sackler and my colleagues, my promoter particularly, Carol Jenkins, for nominating me for this very prestigious award. I would like to dedicate it to all of the women who went before, because wherever you look, if you take the time to look, they're there. Thank you.